welcome to day 11 of Vlogmas. So today is, I suppose, unofficially Boxing Day after we had an early Christmas celebration yesterday. But it's not going to be sitting down, eating chocolates, feet up. I've got a busy day today, Sunday. Lots to do in preparation of the week ahead. But I've got 2 days worth of Advent to open. So I'm really looking forward to catching up on the yarn that I've missed for the last 2 days. Let's open the Advents. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I need to open day 9 and day 10 of the Cuddle Bums. I haven't made any more progress on either of the projects, so I can't share that with you, unfortunately. I can see day 10. Where's day 9? No, what's that one? No. Ah, there it is, right at the bottom. Ooh, look at that. Gorgeous variegated yarn. Look at those colours, mainly yellow. All those beautiful rainbow colours. I love these little 5 gram skeins. I think they're so cute. Right, so that's number 9. Oops. Number 10. I just had to check that I was recording, actually. I had visions of me having forgotten to press the record. Ooh, number 10. Look at that vibrant yellow. That is a proper sunshine yellow, that. Definitely not what's happening with the weather today. It is wet and miserable. We had really high winds last night. I'm sure it said gusts. It was either 53 or 63 miles an hour. Really bad. And funnily enough, I've been speaking to my son and his girlfriend in Australia this morning. They're in Melbourne. And they've had really similar weather to us. Really, really high winds. I think over 100 kilometres an hour. Which is a bit dangerous for them because they're sort of base camp. Because they're travelling around Australia and they're camping in a tent. So it's a bit hair-raising. I think they've had to spend quite a bit of time in the car because the weather's so bad. Right, let's do the cup of tea. I've got the peppermint one today that I opened a couple of days ago. I think I'm going to avoid the dodgy sounding ones. So I may not try all of these, I'll be perfectly honest. So we want number 9. Not there. Ooh, ooh. Number 9. Watch a sunrise. Well, I'm generally up in the morning to potentially see the sunrise. I'm probably still drinking my coffee there, my first cup of coffee of the day. The future is in your hands. Brew it well. Most definitely. You can have your tea however you like it. And that goes for your future as well. So this, oh, I can't believe this. What have I just told you about my son being in Melbourne at the moment and the bad weather? This tea is called Melbourne Breakfast. Oh my goodness, what a coincidence. That really is, isn't it? Oh, right, okay. When the winds start howling, this brew will see you through. Indulge a little with this full-bodied vanilla sweet tea, bound to keep you cosy all year round. Sip it up, Melbourne style. It says it's perfect on its own or with a dash of milk. I cannot quite believe that. Oh my goodness. Right, that's number 9. Number 10. Stretch. I need to do more stretching. I need to go to yoga. I need to get back to it. This one says, tea will warm your soul from the inside out. And this is turmeric ginger ninja. Oh, it's on white writing on orange. It's very hard to read. Bursting with good stuff, thanks to the carrot and ginger, we've given the wholesome herbal a bit of a power-packed turmeric. It's a supercharged organic wonder, so sip loaded with sweet, earthy notes. That one, I'm not sure. I'll brew it and see what it smells like. Right, these are definitely a bit bizarre, these teas, I have to be honest. Right, hook and crutch. Here we go, 9 and 10. Can't wait to see which books these two yarns are based on. Here's number 9. Oh, look at that, very earthy tones there. That is very nice. My sister will definitely like this one as well. I wonder if Jess might make these into full 100 skeins at any point, because if so, I know my sister would like a cowl in this. And the book this is based on, oh, I love this book. I did read it many, many years ago. The Secret Garden. And I loved the TV adaptation. I don't know if it was a film they made or a series, but I can remember as a child, there being a beautiful TV adaptation of it. I like that, very nice. Thank you very much, Jess. Oh, I need my pen to write on it. There we go, number 9 on The Secret Garden. I quite like this opening too on one day. Number 9, I'll pop that in the project bag a bit later. Number 10. Ooh, now they're unusual colours. Again, we've got green, very dark mossy green to limey green and brown. Let's see what book cover this is based on. Verity. No, I've not read that. Verity. Pop number 10 on there, and then I need to add these two to my reading list. I've already started adding them to my Kindle wish list, so I'll be able to download them straight from my Kindle too. So hopefully I'll be inserting the book cover here that Jess has based these on, and you'll be able to compare. Very good, 9 and 10. Well, I'm also going to open a couple of extras I've decided today. So if you haven't opened your extras yet and you want them to be a surprise, then look away. I'll tell you which ones I'm going to open. I'm going to open extra 5 and I'm going to open extra 7. So if you haven't opened 5 and 7, look away now, please. I'll tell you when you can look back. Here we go. Let's do number 7. So that's what number 7 is. And that will go with one of the other items very nicely. There we go. And then number 5. Aha. It's another of my items that I make You can see there, if you read there what it is, you'll know. I'll open it up. So get a bit more of an idea maybe of what that's like. And obviously follows the book theme very well, doesn't it? You can look back now, I've finished doing the extras. Okie dokie, right. So I've opened everything. Biscuits, need biscuits. It's actually lunchtime and I'm about to make some soup with the leftover bits from yesterday's Christmas dinner. But I'll just have one biscuit. You can see they're going down rapidly. My visitors yesterday, we tucked into these. Mid-afternoon snack with a nice frothy coffee. That went down well. They're now looking forward to open their box because they got a box as well from my sister. I think I'll go with this one. This might be the caramel crunch one. Very nice. Very nice indeed. Yummy. So I'll tie the bow back on the box. There we go. All done. Oh, and one more thing to show you. I bought this at the last crochet sanctuary. Isn't it cute? Isn't it cute? Very cute gonk. Christmas gonk. Mini gonk. As you know, I absolutely love gonks. I am gonk mad. And I was delighted that my sister had found some gonk serviettes yesterday, some little napkins. And this is, you've heard me mention her rather a lot on this vlog. And it's Claire from Claire's Made It. And she's also Yarny Gifts on social media. And this is one of the things that she makes. She makes these gonks completely by hand. These are knitted gonks. And I had to have a festive gonk to add to my display. I've got an Easter gonk, coronation gonk, mini gonk. I'm sure I've got more than that. But yes, I'm a bit addicted to her gonks. And just look at that, it's so cute. So I will add him to my display there. Doesn't he look good? So yeah, do pop along and have a look at her Etsy shop. She sells some beautiful handmade items. Right, that is it. Let's taste this tea. Yeah, that's actually all right. That's okay. As I expected, can't really go wrong with peppermint tea. Although this did have a couple of extra bits in, as I recall. Very nice indeed. So thank you so much for watching. I will sign off now and see you again tomorrow for day 11 of Vlogmas. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great day. Bye for now.